friends, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So, as we know, yesterday we have studied our new lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Transportation in animals and plants. Okay? So, in that we are going to discuss about the circulatory system. Already some point we have discussed yesterday. We have discussed about how the blood transported different substances. Also, we have discussed about what the blood contains. Okay, so as we know, the blood contains the different types of the substances, like it contains the liquid or the fluid substance, which we are calling as a plasma. Also, it contains the different blood cells, that is what WBCs and RBCs and the platelets. Okay, but as you know, or have you ever think how this blood is get transported throughout our body or how it gets circulated in our body? So, the blood can get transported in our body, can get circulated in our body along with the some pipe-like structures or along with some tubes, okay? So, the tubes are having a network, that network of the tubes are present in our body, along with that the circulation of the blood takes place, and the tube-like structures are only called as what? Blood vessels, okay? The blood vessels, okay? So, as we know, in our previous lesson, we have discussed in the respiration. Then what happens when we inhale the air, it goes into the lungs. After that, it goes, once it goes into the lungs, then it goes mixed into the blood. Okay, that oxygen gets mixed into the blood. And then that oxygen gets transported to the whole body. But after this process, the next process is what? Exhalation. And what we are doing through the exhalation, that is what? Carbon dioxide. So once the oxygen gets mixed into the blood, it gets transported throughout the body. At the same time, the carbon dioxide gets mixed into the blood and it gets transported to the lungs to purify it. And that carbon dioxide we are throwing out through the exhalation. Okay. So the bloods are doing two-way process. Okay, they carry the oxygen blood also and they carry the carbon dioxide-rich oxide blood also. Okay, so like the two-way process is there, and to perform the two-way process, there are the different vessels are present in the blood, and the name of that blood vessels are what? Arteries and veins. Okay, arteries and veins. So along with these arteries and the veins, the blood can transport it to the different body parts. Okay, but the arteries are having different function and the structure, while veins are also having a different function and a structure. Okay, so let's discuss one by one. First we will go through the arteries. Okay, so these arteries are the blood vessels which carries the oxygen rich air. Very important word, students, keep in the mind, that is what? The arteries always carries the oxygen rich blood from the heart to all the body parts. Okay, so the arteries are the blood vessels which carries the oxygen rich blood from where? From heart to the different body parts. Okay, so see the in the arteries the blood pumps through the heart, that's why the pressure and the force of the blood is more. That is the reason these arteries walls are very thick and flexible. Okay, the arteries wall are very thick and the flexible. Why? Because the blood comes into the artery in a very high pressure. To control that pressure, the walls are thick, and for that pressure, it can get flexibility also. Okay, so that is the reason arteries are being thick and the flexible wall. But in the same point, that is, there is one exception. That is what we have discussed here now, that all the arteries carry the oxygen rich blood. Okay, but one exception is there. There is one artery, that is pulmonary artery. Okay, pulmonary artery is there which carries the carbon dioxide rich blood. Okay, only one exception is there, that is what? Pulmonary artery which carries the carbon dioxide rich blood. Then why it is called as the artery? Because it carries the carbon dioxide blood from the heart only. Okay, so in this way, that is the reason these pulmonary arteries carries only carbon dioxide rich blood. This is the two words you have to keep in the mind, that is what? Arteries carries oxygen rich blood from the heart to the different body parts, but only exception is there, that is what? Pulmonary arteries which carries the carbon dioxide rich blood, right here, that is what? CO2 rich blood. Okay, so this is the first blood vessel, that is what? Arteries. Now we move for the next blood vessel, that is what? Veins. Okay. Now what is mean by veins? So the veins are the blood vessels which carries the carbon dioxide rich blood. Okay. The veins are the blood vessels which carries carbon dioxide rich blood from all body parts to the heart. Okay. So it carries the carbon dioxide blood from the all body parts to the heart. Okay. So since the pressure is less in the veins, it doesn't have any type of the thick walls, but it has the valves. Okay. It presents the valves, like this structure is present into the veins, and because of these valves, what happens? There is only flow in the one direction. If it is go up, it doesn't comes down. It doesn't give the entry for the exit. It gives only entry. Once the blood go inside, it doesn't comes out with the help of these valves. Okay. So in this way, these veins are there, and the veins are having the valves. But like that, we have seen in the arteries, there is one exception, that is the pulmonary artery. Like that, in the vein also, there is one exception, that is what? Pulmonary veins. Okay, there is what? Pulmonary veins. So this pulmonary veins carries the oxygen rich blood. Okay, this pulmonary veins carries oxygen rich blood. That's why it is exception part, because what we said, that the veins always carries what? Carbon dioxide rich blood. But these pulmonary veins carries the oxygen rich blood. Okay. So this is all about arteries and the veins. Now we will discuss the next one part of the next blood vessels, that are what? Capillaries. Okay. So see in the diagram, you can see that at the end you can see some fiber like on the so many lines comes together and it binds together, it gets mixed together. That lines are nothing but what? Capillaries. Okay. So capillaries are the extremely thin blood vessels that connects arteries to veins. Okay. So what is the role of the capillaries? Capillaries are very fine, very thin, extremely thin blood vessels. And what is their function? That connects the arteries to the veins. Okay. So these are the three blood vessels. But for that we will do one activity, that we can find out where are the arteries are present. For that, what we have to do, you have to take your left hand and its index finger you have to keep on your front side of the wrist. Okay, like that we can give, or the inside of your wrist, and then you can feel the thrombing moment. Like that position you have to take. Okay, so like that you have to do and wait for a while, you will feel some thrombing. See in your textbook, and according to that do the procedure properly. So if you do like that, then you can feel some thrombing movement on your hand, and that is nothing but what? What arteries, through the arteries the blood is flowing, and that thrombing movement we can feel over here. So like that, this point is there, we can feel the thrombing movement. Like that, some other points are present in our body, there also we can feel the thrombing of the arteries, that you have to find out and you have to mention in your biology notebook. Okay. So this thrombing of the arteries that we can feel, that is nothing but what? Pulse. It is what? Pulse. So as we know, we are going to the doctor and doctor first checking the pulse. Okay. So with the help of that, we can come to know whether our heart is doing their functions properly or no. Okay. So that thrombing means nothing but what? Pulse. And how much pulse takes place within a 1 minute, it is called as what? Pulse rate. Okay. So the thrombing for the per minute, it is called as what? Pulse rate. And generally the pulse rate for the healthy person, we can say that what? 72 to 80 beats per minute. Okay. So in the healthy adult person, the pulse rate is what? 72 to 80 beats per minute. Means we can say that what? Pulse rate in the heart beats somehow same. So our heart beats for the per minute is what? 72 to 80 beats per minute, because the arteries are connected to the heart. Okay. So once the heart pumps the blood, then we are feeling the thrombing movement. Okay. So this is all about what? Pulse rate and the blood vessels. Okay. So this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video with the next concept. And for today, thank you.